Hello, and welcome to World Cup Dishout. I'm your host, Neil Shah, and as always here with my expert sports presenter and just expert sports gentleman, we have RK. How are you doing?
Awesome. Good to be here.
Good to have you. So we're going to jump into something that I love to talk about is surprises. We all love surprises. And I think back to 2004 when the Euros, when Greece, nobody ever expected that Greece would win the European Championship, but there they were. Then, you know, something more recent to go to 2016. And Iceland out of nowhere makes it to the quarterfinal. And Wales, you know, really has a strong run all the way up until the semifinal, until they lose to Portugal. So now we're in 2018, and we have a familiar Iceland back again. We have other teams, we have Mexico, we have the host, we have Russia as well. And a number of other teams that could come out and be that underdog or that surprise contender as they make it through the next levels of the tournament. I would love to hear from you. What do you think? Who do you think is going to be the surprise? Are there going to be surprises in this 2018 FIFA World Cup?
Well, there could be, definitely. I mean, you looked at, you spoke about 2004. You go back in time to the World Cup that was held in South Korea and Japan. You saw what South Korea was able to do against Italy in that World Cup. So you never know who could do well. But from whatever we have seen in the initial stages of the competition, with most of the teams having played just one game, possibly one or two games, teams having played two, I think, Mexico looked brilliant. Only because of the fact that Mexico beat Germany, a fancy Germany side, a defending champion, to go there and kind of establish yourself and to play the way Mexico did was just brilliant. I mean, look, when you mention Greece, Greece did not play the most entertaining brand of football. Yeah. I mean, they played a very effective brand of football. Most of their wins were 1-0 wins. Yeah. I mean, they did the job, but it's not a side that you will go pay money and watch. Right, so that kind of team. But Mexico was a side that showed courage, and they said, okay, if we've got to beat Germany, we've got to take the attack to them. There's no way we are going to sit back and allow the likes of Cruz and Khedira and Müller and others to play the game and sit back and defend. That's not going to be us. So in that sense, I think Mexico looks brilliant. You mentioned Iceland. I mean, Iceland was slightly different because Iceland played its own game. They were happy to sit back, allow Argentina to come at them. They were able to soak up that pressure and then hit that one goal, which really helped them kickstart that campaign in whatever way that was possible. So different teams, different ideologies. But if you're, I mean, of course, there are a lot many other interesting teams that have done well. Russia, for example, have started very, very well. They've scored plenty of goals. But the real test starts from here on for Russia. Can they sustain the momentum? Because all of a sudden, we're from, you know, possibly even the Russian fans having absolutely no hopes from their side, suddenly the hopes have been kindled. Can they kind of maintain that, momentum? Can they sustain? That's the big question that you need to ask. And of course, we love chatting about Iran, don't we?
Yes, absolutely. We're big Carlos Queiroz fans. And I think if they are able to get out of a group with Spain and Portugal, and the kind of confidence that you have going into the next round is enormous, because both those teams could actually be the 2018 FIFA World Cup winners. And to get out of it means that you could easily be in that same place.
Yeah, and also, I mean, when you look at Iran, I mean, they've got a couple of really, really good players. I mean, it's not the Iran of the old where, obviously they're going to sit back. Of course, they'll sit back. But when you look at, players in that side, you've got a top scorer from the Dutch league. He's done splendidly well for AZ Alkmaar. So, I mean, you've got players which have done there, gone to Europe and proved their mettle. It's not anymore too many of those players playing only in and around Asia. They've gone abroad, they've showed their skill. A couple of their players are even keenly looked at by the clubs, by clubs like Liverpool and Tottenham Hotspur. So they are just beginning to show what they are capable of. So you never know what Iran can do possibly from here on. And hey, Japan has won the opening game. I know you can turn around and say, look, they beat a 10-man Colombia. But look, I mean, there was a foul, there was a red card, and therefore you're down to 10 men. So they've won the game for whatever it is worth. So they picked up 3 points. You never know how far they can go. They did not look the greatest, the most impressive, but a win is a win is a win. So you never know where you're going to head it.
So you know what's missing in this conversation? Africa. I've not heard, usually every World Cup we hear about a Cameroon or a Senegal or somebody who just comes out of nowhere and not just surprises everyone, but excites everyone. And, you know, a lot of times around the world, we fall in love with the African teams just for their humbleness, their their love for the game, the passion of the supporters, and really just the fight that they put on the pitch. But I'm not hearing about any surprise African teams.
Probably Senegal this time around, right? I mean, Senegal has won their opening game. They looked very, very calm and composed on the ball up against a Polish side that promised a lot. I mean, you've got experienced men. I mean, you've got the likes of Blasikowski. I know Blasikowski did not play his full part in the game. You've got Lewandowski. Mm-hmm. So you've got good, solid unit, which is known for its pace with Poland. But somehow on that night against Senegal, they weren't their usual self. Senegal was a far better side, and they were able to withstand the pressure even when Poland scored that goal late in the game. So in that sense, I think Poland, when you look at, say, a side like Morocco, or when you looked at Egypt, probably you would have fancied Egypt a bit better, especially from the group that Egypt found themselves in or find themselves in. But I think Senegal has been a bit of a standout as far as the African nations are concerned. You never know. I mean, with that win under the belt, they could kick on from there.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Well, I look forward to seeing the second round and who comes through and if some of these predictions come to light. So we'll leave it at that for today. We've been sitting here with our expert sports presenter, Mr. RK, and we'll be back with you soon. Keep watching Sportskeeda for more Football World Cup Dish Out. Thank you.